Alright, hello, this is Ralph with Daily Tarot, and today I'm going to do a short video on spiritual counseling and the tarot, and various methods of spiritual counseling, but focusing more on tarot, and using that as a form of spiritual counseling. When people first start going to tarot readers, I think sometimes people enter into it with kind of a skeptical attitude, and they'll go to the tarot reader and try to test them, try to prove them. And I know when I was first learning the tarot, I had this attitude. I remember one time going to a tarot reader at a Renaissance festival in the 1980s, after I'd been studying tarot for about 4 years, and I was still kind of a rookie with reading tarot, because all my information really came out of my own messing around with the cards and reading that skinny little book that comes with the cards. In this case, the book put together by the makers of the Rider-Waite deck, which was very heavily influenced by the ceremonial movement and the Order of the Golden Dawn, which gave kind of a dark interpretation of the cards. And I went to a tarot reader, and I paid $20 for a reading, which at that time I thought was rather expensive. But I was wanting to see if another tarot reader could really read the cards and read me fairly well. So I went before the tarot reader, and wouldn't give him much information about myself. I gave him my name and birth date, and that was it. And every time he turned up a card, I'd kind of smile and look at it, and he'd kind of ask me, okay, I think this indicates, this, that, and the other thing. And would look at me for confirmation, and I'd just be standing there smiling, not giving him any confirmation. And he kind of smiled back and said, okay, I kind of see what's going on here. And, I was testing him, and he knew he was being tested, so he just went on reading the cards without getting any input from me. And he hit the reading really hit the mark. I mean, it would have been a lot easier and a lot better had I participated in the reading and actually given some confirmation, or, added my voice to the conversation. But even without having my voice added to the conversation, he did rather well. And looking back, I see that he was telling me things about myself back then that I was too blind to see about myself. And I see that as happening, in the course of spiritual counseling sessions that I've had, just not involving anything else, not involving tarot cards, or not involving scriptures or anything. Just sitting down with a person and having a little bit of a chat of, by way of saying, okay, how are you today? How are things going? What's going on with your life? A lot of time, people don't fully realize what really is going on in their lives. They have trouble sorting out their own feelings. They have trouble sorting out their own wants and needs and desires. Sometimes we think we know what we want deep inside, but many times we are so cut off, so disconnected from ourselves by our outer worlds, that we really truly don't know what we want. We don't really know what's bugging us. We can know, in a general level that we're not happy, that we're not satisfied, but when asked by somebody, hey, what's wrong? Sometimes we really don't know. And that's where sitting down and having a conversation with a spiritual guider, a spiritual counselor, a guide, can be of great importance, because a lot of times we don't know what's going on in our life. We know something's wrong, but we can't pin it down any further from there. And sitting down and talking things out with another human being, helps to clarify the situation. When we bounce things off of somebody else, they can add their own light to what's going on with us. And we can see ourselves in that light from that other person. And so sitting down and having a conversation with two voices, at least two voices being heard, our voice and the voice of the other person, sheds light on what's going on with ourselves, with our inner world. And that is how I see the benefit of using tarot. Because when you have the cards coming up in a reading, and you're sitting down with another person, you're really having a conversation with three voices being heard. You know, your voice, the voice of the reader, and the voice of the tarot card speaking to us through universal images and archetypes, which express spiritual truths. And we can find out more about what's going on. Like if we have a reading, I did this morning for a certain group, and a card like this turns up. We're having some lighting troubles here, but yeah, this is the Nine of Swords, and this is the Worry card. This card speaks to fears. In general, you know, fears, worries, says something's wrong. And of course, wow, great revelation, something's wrong. But the card that followed it was this one, and let's see if we can get this one going here. Okay, the light is kind of bad here, but okay, King of Pentacles is what this one is. And King of Pentacles speaks to material things, material success, money problems, can also could possibly indicate family problems, but you know, I would tend to think that would be more in the realm of the King of Cups. But you know, the King of Pentacles speaks of power in the realm of finance, of earthly affairs, of power and political power. And so if we're trying to narrow down what our worries are, and you just have a person that just has a vague understanding, perhaps they're living in denial. They've been taught from an early age that, hey, everything's fine. Everything's great. I've got no worries. I've got no problems. But yet, you know, their life is just so totally messed up that it's obvious that they're out of sync. They're out of touch. And so having those two cards come up in a reading can indicate, yeah, you do have troubles. You do have worries. You do have problems. Now admit it. And those problems that are eating your lunch right now have to do with material things. So what's going on in your material life? Is there a problem at work? You know, and slowly, having a conversation with a person in a non-confrontational way, just an open chit-chat, can reveal so much. When you have two and three voices speaking, you know, the voice of the client, the person in trouble, the voice of the spiritual guide, the reader, who's trying to help that person see their trouble and overcome it. And then the third voice being the cards, the tarot, suggesting to us through the images, through the pictures, what the trouble may be, you know, where the worries are, and how we can successfully overcome them. So, I mean, that's my take on it. What I did back in the 1980s with that one tarot reader who turned out to be the Reverend Don Lewis, who is now, I've come back into communication with him some 30 years later, and I'm broadening my tarot skills once more through his, help and aid. What I did back in the 1980s was a test, and looking back, I can see it wasn't a proper thing to have done. Because really, had I put my own voice, allowed my own voice to be heard in that $20 tarot reading, I really would have gotten my money's worth. As it was, you know, remaining silent and just smiling like a fool, which is another tarot card, come to think of it. But I did get my money's worth, but not totally. Not as much as I could have done. You know, had I availed myself of the skills of a very good, very accomplished tarot reader. But I did learn something. And, looking back on it, I think one of those lessons is, don't stand by quietly. Don't be silent. Speak your peace. Speak your mind. Even if it is only, I don't know, something's wrong and I don't know what it is. And allow your voice to be heard in the discussion. And then as we're speaking together, three of us, the querent, the reader, and the cards, we can narrow down what's going on and offer some sound spiritual advice as to how to live a better future and how to be a moving force, an active participant in our present and in our future, learning from past mistakes. So this is Ralph saying so long, and see you again later. If you have any questions, comments, please don't hesitate to contact me. I'm going to put all of our contact information at the bottom of this video. So blessings, and we'll talk to you all later.